Hey guys, I finished this month's OC drawing really at the last moment, but I did it. And yeah, actually I nearly forget about this and remembered just in the middle of April that I still have to draw OC picture for this month. At that time I was a little bit panicking, so that I'm now even more happy about the fact that I finished it just in time. I edited this video right after I finished the drawing yesterday, and yeah, first I didn't want to make a voiceover for it at all. And yeah, that's all because many things happened during this past month and I had to think about a lot of things, and I don't want to bother you with that, but just let me tell you that my motivation to draw wasn't the greatest at that time, and I'm still now not in the greatest mood. But yeah, life goes on. So, the reason why I'm doing this voiceover nevertheless is because this drawing of my character Reese expresses kind of my inner feelings during the last months really well. As I started with the sketch, I really wasn't intending this picture to be like that. But the more and more I worked on this piece, I felt kind of a connection to her. And it sounds a little bit stupid to say something like that, but I just can't describe it otherwise. Maybe this drawing didn't become perfect, but for myself, it is. And it's really the first time I felt something like that for a drawing of mine. It took a really special place in my heart, and that's why I had to do this voiceover. But for now, let's put that aside. After all, you're here for the drawing. At least, I think so. So, this OC drawing is the first one I created with watercolors. Already, as I was doing the sketch for this, I imagined that it would look better this way. Also, I didn't use watercolor in a long time. So, this time I did a complete line art with multi-liners in before. That was kinda difficult, cause the paper here is glued on the edges so that it didn't become wavy at the end. However, this way I couldn't use my light table to transfer the messy sketch on the watercolor paper. So I had to recreate the whole sketch without as many mistakes as possible, and surprisingly it worked pretty well. As for the coloring techniques that I used within this piece, I first put down a basic layer on each different part of her. So I started with the skin, then the hair, and so on, like you can see it in the video. For the skin, I mostly used a red on red technique, so to make the shading really soft. So after one layer dried completely, I went over it with clear water again and put down some more skin tone on the parts that should be darker at the end. Therefore, I also mixed some purple in the skin tone. Another technique that I used very often is the wet on dry technique. So I put down a bit of wet color on a dry area and blended it out. Sometimes I also just put down the next layer of shades on top of the dry base color without blending it. You can see that especially well on the upper part of her dress. I really like using this on some parts, cause this way the natural look of the watercolor spreads out very nicely. For her crown and the pattern on her dress, I used my liquid gold watercolor so that it becomes shiny and glittering. Yeah, cause as you may can tell, Reese is a princess. So more like she's forced to be one. Reese is after Curie the second OC I've ever created, and that's why it wasn't really difficult for me to draw her. Maybe you saw her already somewhere on my channel. The special thing here is that I only designed her casual outfit yet, and so this was the first time for me drawing her in this version. I designed this dress with the thought of being very much princess-like. However, she hates it herself. She hates everything about being in this position, but she isn't able to get out of this cage that she's captured in like a bird. At all costs, she wants to be free and wants to get out of this, but she stays. 'Cause that's why she's aware of the fact that if she'll get out of it, she will hurt someone else. Yeah, that was a little excerpt out of her background story. I already told a little bit more about her in my last watercolor video, where I practiced on drawing backgrounds. So if you wanna know a little bit more about her, just check that out. I will put down a link to that in the description box. There you also can find all the material I used for this and also a link to my social media. Since some time I also got Instagram, so if you're interested in, just check that out too. Yeah, that's all I have for you at the moment. Just enjoy the rest of the video and then see you soon!